Week, of course, Ronna McDaniel, the past chair of the RNC for the last three election cycles, won reelection. So she will once again, for at least the next 2 years, actually, to be honest, I don't even know how frequently they hold these elections. But for the next couple years, she is going to be in charge of the RNC again, which is wonderful because she's really, really bad at it. Now, here's the thing. A lot of Republicans are not happy about this. Not because they think she's a perennial loser and they think they can do better, but because they wanted their own MAGA freaks to be the ones taking over the party. They wanted Harit Dillon, who has served as a Donald Trump lawyer, calling the shots, but instead they got more years of Ronna McDaniel, who, for the record, was actually handpicked by Donald Trump to be the chair of the RNC after he won in 2016. So, not exactly sure why they don't think she's a Trump loyalist, because she 100% is. And to be honest, that's what's caused her a lot of problems and caused her a lot of losing. But nevertheless, on Monday, Steve Bannon goes on his idiotic little podcast and he says this. There's a lot to talk about the RNC. I understand you guys are still worked up. Whatever you do, don't send them any money. Just take a deep breath. There's going to be a program and a plan for all of it. Just take a deep breath. A little cryptic, right? Like, don't worry. Y'all just breathe. We're going to have a plan. We're going to have a program. Don't send them any money. Just breathe. We got it. Right? Super creepy. But most importantly, it's the don't send them money thing. You do understand, Steve, that you're still a part of that Republican Party. And when it comes to being a money-churning apparatus, you really can't beat the RNC. I mean, love them, hate them, doesn't matter. Ronna McDaniel still does a damn good job raising money. In fact, that's the only thing she is good at. She sucks at winning, but she's dang good at raising money, which is basically why she won re-election. But if Steve Bannon is out there telling his average everyday Republicans do not send the Republican Party any money, that is going to hurt that party, right? You can't tell your grassroots funders to stop giving to the party, because that is who listens to Steve Bannon. You don't have the CEO of Exxon tuning into War Room with Bannon every day. So you're basically kneecapping your own party. Once again, sending them right back into the arms of those corporations that they now claim are woke and corporations are mad about, but they're still not going to stop giving money to the Republicans. So the whole thing is pretty stupid, but it is indicative that even though the fight for the RNC chair is over, the civil war within the Republican Party is not even close to being finished, which, as I always say, is a good thing. When Republicans are busy fighting each other, it gives them less time to hurt the rest of the country. So let's hope they keep it up. They can just fight each other all they want for the next few years till the next chair election, however long they want to do it. Wonderful. I'm all for it. Because if they're doing that, then they're not working on legislation or culture war nonsense that's going to hurt you. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.